So if you could just move a little bit closer, so I don't need to strain my voice. Cool. So my name is Carissa, and I lead the hardware marketing team based out of Singapore. And I'm super excited to be here to introduce you to the Pixel 2 XL, which is coming to Singapore on the 15th of November through our partnership with Singtel. Excuse me. So the Pixel 2 XL is really built on the belief that you need to ask more from your phone. And at Google, basically, we're bringing you the Pixel, the best of hardware, software, and artificial intelligence, or AI, to create a phone that's smart, but also simple and safe. And we really believe that, you know, our job is to basically provide you with the tools and then get out of the way, right? So Pixel 2 XL is launching in two colors. So we have black, or just black, actually, and black and white. Today, we also announced Singaporean the assistant being available in Singaporean English. So what that means is that we're actually going to be able to understand Singaporean accents much better. So we have improved voice recognition, and we're going to be able to provide much more locally relevant information for people here in Singapore. So before you go out and like experience the demo zones, I just wanted to show a few other quick new features that we've added to the Pixel 2 XL. Which hopefully, you know, make the phone like a lot more helpful to all you guys. So the first thing is that we have something called an always-on display. So basically, you always see the time and the date and the notification icons if you do have notifications, right? So if a notification pops up, what's going to happen is you'll see a preview, and then it collapses and becomes the icon. And I tend to ignore my notifications, so you can see I have a bunch of them kind of over here. So that's the first thing with just in the sleep or lock screen. The second thing that's really cool is something we're calling Now Play. So you're out and about, you're sitting in your car, there's music playing in the background, and you kind of want to know, okay, what song is that? So let's see if this works.
It will work.
It will work, yes. So then the title of the song and the artist actually appears on the screen, and you can just glance at it.
So you don't have to.
You don't have to do anything.
No.
No.
It just comes up.
It just comes up, right?
Oh, how is it?
So it just comes up. How Long by Charlie Puth.
So Now Playing is not turned on by default.
Oh, you yes. You need to go. So I can tell you how in a sec. So I'm not very cool. I don't know this guy, but if I double tap, I think I'm too old. It actually opens the assistant and then takes me to this card where, you know, I can click on the full lyrics, I can maybe go into YouTube, and it takes me straight to the YouTube video.
Or Spotify as well.
Or Spotify, exactly. So that's a pretty cool feature. And what's really cool about it is that it actually all happens on the device. So there's no information that's sent to a server or to Google. It's all music and audio. Just music on the device itself. So even on airplane mode, the feature actually works.
Oh, cool.
And if you want to turn it on, you basically go into settings, sound, advanced, and then Now Play down below.
How long does it need before it identifies? How long does it need to listen before it identifies the sound?
Actually take about 5 to 20 seconds.
Yeah.
So it takes a while, and of course it is actually reading and studying sort of like the music and matching it to the song database that's on device. So it actually triggers off every 1 minute. So if it misses it, it might do it the next minute. So that would help it to also consume less power, and it's something that you need to turn on in your phone.
Does it also work on local songs, for example, a Philippine song or a Singaporean song?
It actually pulls from the local Google Play Music catalog, and it's like tens of thousands of songs. So for Singapore, we don't have Google Play Music, so we're pulling it from the Google Play Music US version.
And actually, it also updates on a weekly basis. So, you know, when new songs are added to the catalog, it does get updated onto the device. So that's Now Playing. Another thing that's new with the Pixel 2 XL actually is that we've moved the quick search bar to the bottom of the device, so it's much easier to access. You know, we usually hold our phones this way. You can just click on the search bar and you get this page, right? I can start searching for Spotify, for SpongeBob SquarePants. So, you know, automatically stuff comes out based on the few letters that I type. Things from the web and things from my phone. And let's say I see the Spotify app and I want to put it on my home screen, I can just drag it over there. So again, just a nifty little feature that makes things a little bit easier. Something that we're also really proud of are the front-facing speakers on the device. So sound quality is really good.
Super good.
Let me skip this ad. This song is also not cool anymore, but I do know it. So you can hear sort of the great sound quality coming from the front-facing speakers. And the last thing I want to show you, since a bunch of you are YouTubers, is that you can watch the videos actually in a full screen mode on YouTube. So if I do that, suddenly it's much bigger, much more immersive, and you don't have the black bars.
And you can fast forward and rewind.
Yes, and you can fast. Okay.
Wow.
You know a lot about the device.
Then we can picture in picture kind of thing.
Double tap.
Picture kind of. Picture. Like, so the YouTube video can be like, you can do something else on the screen and it can still be playing.
Yeah. You can minimize it and make it smaller.
Can I add more pages?
I just did,
page.
Sorry, I didn't show it to you.
Sorry.
So that's really it for me. So I just wanted to show you a few quick little things before you actually go into the more immersive demo experiences outside. And you're going to start off actually touching and feeling our new headphones, the Google Pixel Buds.